Hi everyone, today video is on Fluent Validation Library. It is a .NET Core library. So using that we are going to validate our web application models. Okay. So what is Fluent Validation Library? Fluent Validation is a popular .NET library for enabling the validation rules. It has lot of features like inbuilt validation rules that are most commonly used in any application, and also has flexible support for creating our custom rules as well. Okay, so it has built in lot of default rules like email validation, phone number validation, length, like that. Lot of built in validations are available with this library, and also it gives the flexibility to create whatever type of custom validation rule by ourselves. Okay, implementing Fluent validation rule is cleaner approach than using the data annotations, where data annotation is a .NET default implementation for applying validation rule. So I think everyone know about the data annotations, where we can apply the validation of a model by adding the attributes on top of every field. Okay, so within the class only, on the each property we will add attributes. That validation is nothing but .NET validation. But in Fluent validation, we will not do directly that kind of validation directly within our class only. We won't create. Okay, we will create a separate validation mapper class. So in that we can define our validation rules. Okay. So, and also one of the benefit of this Fluent validation is, instead of a third party library, it can automatically inject it into .NET Core model validation without any explicit implementation. That is one of the future that comes with the Fluent validation library. Okay, so it is much more compatible with the .NET Core, and it works like a default validation only. Okay, so how to implement data Fluent validation to a model? So to apply a Fluent validation to a model, we have to create a separate validator class. The validator class must inherit the Fluent validation dot abstract validator of specific type. Inside of the constructor, we need to apply the validation properties of the specified type. So here you can see, right here I have a student class. So if I want to apply a validation rules using Fluent validation, then what I have to do means I need to create a separate class for that model, student model. See here, you can see another class, that is student validator, that should inherit. Okay, if we want to make the student validator as a validator class for our student class, then we should inherit abstract validator that loads from the Fluent validator library. And also in that abstract validator, we must define to which model we are trying to create the validator. Okay, since I am creating for student, right, I need to create that type. So inside of the constructor, we need to specify the rules for the each property. See, name, age, are these properties are from the student class. To this, we are applying rules like, see, these are the default built-in rules I have mentioned, right? Those are these method names, like not null, means name cannot be empty. And age. Greater than 10. I am specifying student age must be greater than 10. So these are the rules validation like this. This is a sample how we can create a validator using the Fluent validation. Okay. So here I want to show you some of the built-in Fluent validation provider methods. Like you can see here, not null validator. So here we can specify rule for unname, and you can, right, not null. Similarly, not empty. Okay. Next, not equal to. Not equals to, you can either specify directly a constant string, or you can compare between the two properties. See here, I have comparing with the name and nickname, like that. Okay. And equal validator. Here also, you can either specify constant or compare with another property. And length, where our string length must be between the here I have specified 150, right? 150 only, inclusive of 150 as well. Okay. If it is 0 or 60, this validation will be fired. and max length operator, min length validator, and less than validator, and less than or equal to validator, and greater than or equal to validator, and and regular expressions, email validator, and a credit card validator, and null validator. So these are the major are most commonly built-in validators that I have shown here. Here I want to show you a small overview how we can implement in .NET core application. So what I'm doing is here I'm creating .NET 5 MVC application. So I can show you how the model validation can be fired automatically using the Fluent validator. So let's jump into creating the project. Okay, here I am selecting model view controller template. Okay, so here I have named my project and solution as well, and I have defined my path. And you can see I am targeting latest framework, that is .NET 5. Let's create the project. So project successfully created. Okay, so first thing is I want to install the package for our Fluent validation. Okay, so go to NuGet. In the dependencies, you can right click and manage NuGet packages, and go to the browse tab and search like Fluent. See, here you can see Fluent validation, Fluent dependency injection, and Fluent ASP.NET Core, right? So what I will do, I'm going to use the Fluent validation.asp.NET Core that will compatible with our .NET Core directly. Okay, so stable version 10.3.3, I'm going to install. So here green tick mark, you can observe that our library has been successfully installed. Okay, now the first thing is we have to configure the service in the startup.cs file, which service means Fluent validation service. Okay, so that it can we can add some configurations on while progressing our demo. Okay, since I have mentioned, right, this Fluent validation.asp.NET Core library is highly compatible with our .NET Core. So to enable MVC model validations or Web API also, in Web API, you will have, I think, add controller service. Here you will have add with controller with MVC. Okay, so we need to extend it here. Okay, like add Fluent validate, okay, Fluent validation service, add Fluent validation service. Okay, like this we need to register the service. Okay, next thing is let me create a model, and I want to do validation for that model. Okay, so now I will create a model like person model. Okay, so in the models, I'm creating like person view model. Okay, so this is the model. Let's have some properties for our testing. So my model looks like this after adding the few sample properties. So now I want to create a model validator. So model validator means in general, let me show you how we can use data annotation. Data annotation means like this we will do. Okay, for the demo purpose I am showing. So it is asking us to install data annotation extension. Okay, in general we will directly add validations and model, but in Fluent validation it is different. We will create separate class. Okay, so let me create a person view model validator class. Okay. Okay, let's create a folder like validators. Okay, so let's create person view model validator class. Okay, this is my person view validator class. So to make it as a validator for our person view model, what we have to do means we need to inherit the abstract validator from the fluent validation. Okay. So what I can do, fluent validation dot abstract validator. Okay. So I will remove this. Okay, and we have to specify our for which model we want to add our validation, that is person view model. Okay, now inside of the constructors, I have shown you, right, some built-in functionalities. Like them, I will add few rules for the few properties. Okay, to add that, you can use method like rule for, and you have to define your method name. So what I will do, I will specify like not null. Okay, and if you want, you can add n number of built-in rules, not empty, not equal. Okay, all will be fired for the each property. Like that, you can add n number of extension values. Okay, so let me add only not null for our demo, and let me add one more rule. Okay, and let me add it for age. Age must be greater than 5. Okay, so I have applied two rules for my model. Okay, so let's to test it, we will create a MVC endpoint. Okay, so let's create MVC empty controller. I will name it like person. So this is our person controller. Okay. So let me add, if you don't specify also not a problem. I am specifying explicitly my routes. Okay. So let me create a one more action method, that is like I action create. Okay. So here I will specify a route like, so first is HTTP get to load the form. Okay, this method, this action method will load the one form where user can enter some data. Okay, because validations are meant for to validate against the post data, right? So I want to post some form data. Okay, that is I am creating now. So I will simply return view. Okay, and let me create same action method, duplicate it for post. Okay, for data posting. So I will change the attribute like HTTP post, and here method will have input parameter. Now it will be a overloaded method. Okay, so I have person view model, right? Okay, so here we need to validate like normal MVC model validation, like model state dot is valid. So if it is valid, what I will do, I will simply return a string content. Okay, for demo purpose, string will be rendered, or else I want to load same form with error messages. Okay, so I will simply pass the model so that error messages will be automatically rendered on the page. Okay, now let's create our view as well, browser page. So inside of the views, let's create a folder like person. Okay, so inside of persons, and name it like our method is create create, right? So same convention, it will search for the view HTML file as well. If you want to specify different namespace, then you have to pass your path name as well. I think you know that basic thing. Okay, so first let's define our model, HTML model. Okay, model is defined. So let me add some HTML, form HTML. So this is my form HTML. So I have copied some code snippets so that we can save some time. Okay, if you observe here, see, this is one text box and this is another text box, and here it is button. And here in the action method, I am passing my action method name, that is create and post. On clicking button, it should post. Okay, and here you can see first name is coming from our model. This is a .NET binding. Okay, here you can see intelligence first name. So we have only applied rules for which one thing, first name and age, right? So for testing, I have added only those two fields. Okay, so it will be video will be quicker. So label first name here, ASP first name here, validation for also first name. This should be mandatory to render our error messages. Okay, these are normal MVC only, not fluent validation. But fluent validation will be injects its error messages into normal .NET Core error message handlers. Okay, nothing but model state it will inject implicitly, everything implicitly. There is no configuration required for that. Okay, so this is first name and here is age, same way. Okay, so let's test this endpoint. Okay, so this is our page, like person slash create. Okay, let's submit with empty fields and check what will happen. So here if you observe, name didn't find any validation, but age is firing. Why only name not firing, age is not firing? Actually, this is not a fluent validation. It is a normal validation by the MVC because our age is not nullable, right? So here it is not nullable, but our field is empty, right? So normal MVC is firing. So let me make it optional. Okay, and if I reload again, okay, now let's submit again. Now normal validation also won't fire. It's gone to success. That is correct only because model state didn't find any validation rules, because here we don't specify any data annotation rules. That is one case, model validation don't know. But we have created a model validator, that is our person view model validator, that is fluent validation. So our framework don't know about this fluent validation model, because we should register this model with this model in the startup. Okay, then only automatically framework can consider thus that fluent validation also for validation. Okay, so to registering these models, there are different ways. Okay, so one such way is individually we can specify them with the scope, or you can specify here itself in the options. We have to configure one options like option dot register validation assembly containing. Okay, but it is expecting some variable from which library. So I want to load all the validations, okay, of this project anywhere those are created. Okay, either they created in controller or a model. General, we will create a only in validators folder only. But in such a way I want to specify means in this folder, sorry, in this project, anywhere if you find fluent validation library, let's load into your configuration. So to do that, we have to specify a class that is under the root namespace. So if you observe here, only two classes are available, like program and startup.cs. Any one of the name if you specify, that is enough. Framework can take care of this. So here I will specify startup only. Okay. Because this is startup class only, right? This is under root folder. Or if you don't want to enter root folder, you can specify in here if you have 100 of validation classes. If you specify one class name, that is fine. If you want to specify, you can specify one class name. So this is not registering this class only. This is registering the namespace of this class. So what is the namespace? Validator. So what it will do means it will load all the model validators within this folder. Nothing but this namespace. Okay. But in general, what they will do means they will specify like root. Okay. That's why I'm using startup. If you don't want startup, means if you don't want framework to search all the files in the library and want to only search in the validators folders only, then simply give any one class name, any one class name. Okay. So it can load every validators in that folder. Okay. Now I am registered, successfully registered my validation. So let's go to our web application and test. Now validations will definitely fire. Okay. So I have loaded my site and I'm clicking submit. Let me specify like 4 and submit. Age must be greater than 0. Okay. That is because if empty, why it is not firing means that is empty. That validation rule is only for let's go to that validation rule. Only for greater than 5. That doesn't understand not null. So if you want fire for not null also, you can specify not null. Now you will get error. Now if I click, see, age cannot be empty. And if I specify 0 also, it will be error. See, age must be greater than 0. And first name must be empty because of this rule, not null rule. Okay. So that's it. And let me show you custom message as well. Hello. Error. Okay. Let's load our website. Okay. Submit here. See, hello error, our custom message. Okay. And if you want property name, here there is a concept called placeholders, I believe. Simply specify a property name. So what will happen means this property name will be rendered here automatically. So let's test this as well. First name automatically we got. Hello error. So like that you can customize your messages as well. Okay. That is one option. Now I want to show how to fire the validations for the child classes, parent and child classes. So let's create a one child model. Like person address view model. Okay. Okay. This will be my child class. Okay. For the person model. So let me create a navigation property. Okay. I will name it like person address. Okay. Let's add one property like public string address. Okay. So this is my class address, child class property, string, simple address string. Okay. So we have to specify its own validation rule class. Okay. You cannot create within the parent class validation rule. We have to create a separate view means validator class for this child class as well. Okay. So let me create the validator class. Go to validators. Okay. And we know that we need to inherit the abstract model that is from Fluent validator, right? So let me do that. Let's name it clearly. वैलिडेटर। ओके सो लेट्स इनहेरिट आवर एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड दैट लोड्स फ्रॉम द फ्लुएंट वैलिडेशन। आई नीड टू स्पेसिफाई द नेम ऑफ द माय मॉडल दैट आई वांट टू वैलिडेट। ओके सिंपली पास दैट वन एंड इट इज एक्सपेक्टिंग सम नेम स्पेस। ओके लेट्स ऐड कंट्रोलर and only one property like right, so let me add my rule. Okay, address and rule like not null. Okay, let's have a one more field that represents our a child class. So let's duplicate this one. Okay, and change it like address. And here address person address dot address person address dot address, and here also validation also person address dot address. Okay, so let's run and whether check the child class validations are firing perfectly or not. Okay now we got third field as well. Let's submit. If you observe here, address is not firing. It means child class properties are not firing. Yes, child class properties validation won't fire directly. We have to either explicitly call validation or we need to add one more configuration in the startup. So let's add the one more configuration so that automatically along with the parent class, child class validation rules also will fire. Okay. And here in the options dot implicitly validate child properties equal to true. By default it is false. Now we made it as true. Now let's check the our website. See, it is fired. Okay, let me show you again get method. If I submit, the address must not be empty. So this implicit validation child property enables automatic validation of the child properties as well. Okay, and next thing is I want to mention about the one more feature provided by the Fluent validation, that is customize validate attribute. Okay, what it is and why it is, I will explain you now with a sample. Okay, so it is an attribute Fluent validations dot ASP.NET Core dot customize validator. Okay, so let me remove this namespace and import the namespace. Okay, so this attribute is provided by the Fluent validation. What is the benefit of means? Here there is a option like properties. And here I can specify comma separated property names. Okay, so if I have age, what are the properties I have? Last name, first name, ID, age. But last name, first name only we have validation rules, right? If you observe in a person view model, we have only rules are first name and last name. So what is the beauty of this customized validator means? Only specified properties, only validations will be fired. The properties which are doesn't specify, those validations will be ignored. So let's test it. So first I want to test for age. So let's add, okay. Okay, I'm submitting now. I have specified age only, I should fire age only. I haven't specified name, right? It won't fire, okay. See, name won't fire. And one more limitation you have to understand means it won't show any effect on child properties. That is why it is firing. Okay. Only customized attribute only applies for parent properties. Okay. Sorry, first name, I believe. Property name. Okay. See, now name is firing. Right. If I specify comma separated, then both will fire. So what happens means this customization providing us optional way of firing the property so that same model can be used for different actions method based on their requirement, right? So it will give some little control over our validations, which to fire and which to not fire. So let's test this case as well. Now both will fire. The only limitation is it won't affect on the chained properties. Okay, now all are fine. Okay. So that's about the basic overview on fluent validation, how to integrate and what are the key features, how to validate in our MVC application. Same thing, model validation. See, this model state validation is a .NET model validation, but this validation is firing for fluent validation also. That is because it is internally injecting those errors, fluent validation errors, into our MVC model state validation. Okay. So same thing can be applied for web API as well. If you want to fire validations using this fluent validator, that also absolutely fire. It will work as similar as data annotation, but it is more clearer because we are separating validations from our normal models. Okay. So that's all about the fluent validations. I hope this video has delivered some useful information to you all. If you like my video, please support me by subscribing to my channel. Soon we will meet with the new videos. Until then, signing off.